Hi all, welcome to my channel, welcome to my world. This is the world of Wayne. This is going to be really emotional. This is because we've finally got the last pack from Agora Models of Build the Terminator T-800. Now pack 12 consists of stages 111 all the way to 120. Going to finish it completely. Now we've already done the Terminator, although we've got no way to turn it on at the moment, and that's why in this issue you do have a remote control right at the very end to operate everything you see us putting together at the moment. But we will be building the base, which we started on in the last pack. Now if you want to get this for yourself, put the link down here to the Agora Models website. You can get this all the way from pack one. We do have other things over at the Agora Models website as well. You've got the Shelby Super Snake, you've got the Cobra, you've got the Leopard Tank, you've got the Bismarck. There's loads out at the moment, and in September we have got the Jaguar E-Type coming out as well. But I know you're all interested in the Terminator T-800, so without further ado, let's get cracking. So we should be quite a dab hand at this because we have done it two times before. So what we're going to do is take the lens, put it down this way in here, make sure it's sitting flat in that section, just like that. We're going to take a back piece and thread the wire through this section here. And then what we want, when it's all the way through, is the wire to come in out the back section, just like that. We're gonna piece all of this together, just like that, so it fits all in one place. We're gonna hold this together with 2x4mm screws. So I've got them here, these are just the silver screws here. And we'll put four of these in to keep this all in one place. And there we go, that's four screws in. Turn it upside down, I've got a lens here to put in. The lens just pushes into the top here, so it fits nice and flush on there. Then we're going to be putting this on a branch or a stalk, which means that we're going to be feeding this all the way through there till it comes out the other side. And then we're going to be putting these two holes together so we can put a screw through here. But when we do this, we want to make sure that we're not pinching the wire in between. So that should be on like that. Now we've got a hole for a nut. So we're going to drop a nut in one side, just like that. Hold it, turn it over, and then using one of the large black screws we've got here, that's just going to go into the other side there. And then tighten that up. And that is one spotlight done. And as you can see, you can tilt it either way to direct that before it goes into the base. So that's the red one. So I'm going to keep that to one side. And we're going to do exactly the same thing for the blue one. So I'm just finalizing up all the screws for the blue light, which is exactly the same as what we've just done. Actually whizzing through this because this will be the fourth time we've done this now. But these lights will be impactful on the final finished Terminator. So they're in. Put the lens in the top, push it down so it's nice and flat, put the stalk on, threading the cable through, make sure we're not pinching the wire, that looks good, put the final nut in, turn it over and hold that together with the large black screw we got here, and then tighten that up. And there you go, that's the blue one done. So I've got the blue one in my left hand, the red one in my right hand. That's all there is to do in that stage. Now in stage 112, we're going to continue building on the base. And this time we have a lot of details for a skull backbone, some jaws. We've also got some screws and a plate here to actually join this to the base we've been working on previously. And that's going to be the first thing we want to do. So this is the base here, but we're going to bring over the base we've been working on. And this is going to match onto this section just here. Now it's going to be held in with a tab, pretty similar to what happened on this one here. So I'm going to hold that together just with my hands for the minute, put the metal tab over the top just to lock that in. and then take one of the flange screws here, which is a PWB screw. We're just gonna tighten that up. So that's the first screw in. I'll make that nice and tight. And here's the second. That's already held these two pieces together. And then quite easily, we can actually just put the other two in now. No problems at all. And when they're in, should look like that. So I can turn this over. And now we've got some details that we need to glue in here. So the first one is this jaw section, looking like that. And rather than put glue on the bottom here, I'm actually just going to put it around the edge, because it's the edge that's going to bind to the base section here. So because it needs quite a bit of glue, I'm just going to trace it round rather than put it on with my thing that I normally put it on with, and then just push that into place. So that's the jaw section in. We've then got this skull section to put in here, and it's these three lugs on that that we're interested in, because they're going to go into the three holes that we got here. So I'll put this in. I think you can see this just about on the top camera there. And there you go, that's the spine in. And then the last thing we've got is just this little rock here. That's just going to go into this section here. It's got a shape, so it's pretty easy to see how this goes. And there we go, that's the rock on, just like that. We're then going to take one of the spotlights. So it doesn't actually say what spotlight to take. So I've got the blue one here, because in the magazine they put masking tape on the red ones. That's just going to go into this section here. I could always change this around afterwards. It's not a big worry. And then this will go in, pressing together the plastic tips on this, just like that. And then that tilts, just like the rest of them there. It's going to face up to the Terminator when it's standing here. And that's all there is to do in that stage. Now in the next stage of the Terminator, we've got another part of the base. This is the final part of the base. And it's going to attach to the others exactly like we've seen before. Now this is probably going to be best on the side camera here. But quite simply, this one's just going to go into this side here. But this time we're going to be putting two tabs, one on this section just here, then one on this section here. And once again, it's PWB screws. So I'll just put the tab in first on each one of these sides, and then I'll offer this plate up here to the other side. So they're attached. Now I'll bring this up, and then that will enable me to get one screw in this side. One in the other side. Now that's held that in, so I can just put the last two screws in each plate. And there we go, that's those plates in. So I can turn this back around now. And now we've got some more details to put into place. So we do have the skull that we had previously. This doesn't get glued down. This basically is just going to sit into the base like that. Now this detail here, as you see, it's got a shape at the bottom here. That's just going to go into this section here. So I'll just put a bit of glue in there. That should be ample to push this into place. And it's pretty much just a case of lining up the parts to the shapes. It's that easy. So we've got a mechanical detail here. It's just going to go in there. We've got a rock, which is just going on top of that. As you can see, I'm being very blasé with the glue, because it's probably going to need quite a fair chunk of glue to keep these parts into place. And then the last two parts we've got, which are tangled together on mine, are these two springs. Now you can put these pretty much where you like, but one spring goes into these grooves that you can see here, just to the side of the jaw. So I'm just putting that in so it sits by itself. Now it is metal going onto sort of like a plastic, so that might take a little while to set. And the second one, just over this side here, Just going to see how this lies. Kind of like that, but it is your model, so you can decide where you want those. All we've got to do then is just take the red spotlight that we got here. That's the last one left. Thread that through the only hole that we got left for a spotlight to go. And then we'll clip that into place. And that's all the spotlights in. And that's all there is to do in that stage. Now, quite an easy stage 114, because all we've gonna do is install the circuit board looking like this. So we're gonna bring over the base. I've already taken the skull off again and turned this upside down. If any of the springs fall off, then obviously just put that back in afterwards, but there you go. Now that is going into these four holes that we can see on this section here, and it's gonna be this way round, so that the three sections at the top are facing this join here. Line it up with the holes there, and then using the supply 2x4mm screws, we're just going to screw the circuit board in. So that's one, two, three, and four. And then we're going to plug these wires in. Now this is a red light coming from this side. That's going to be plugged into the top section just here. Just make sure that's pushed all the way down, which means on the other side here we're going to have a blue light, which is going down here. And then similar fashion, down the bottom here, we've got one for the red light here, which will be this side. And one for the blue light, which will be on the other side there. Now we will be routing around these cables to ensure they're not pinched down, but that is all there is to do in that stage. In stage 115, we're going to be installing the speaker here. We do have this lovely bit of base here. It's basically wooden on one side, and it's got this lovely velvet material on the other, but I'm going to keep that to one side for a second. Because what we need to do, bring over the base that we've been working on again. And in this section where the skull is going to go, we're actually going to be putting a switch in. Now, the way they've got the switch in the magazine is that the off position, the circle there, is towards this flat edge here. So this is just going to be threaded through here all the way down and then just pushed into place just like that. And then you want to check that you can operate the switch, no problems at all. Turn it over because we need to plug that switch in, and the switch is going to be plugged into this socket that we can just see here. So get it lined up and then push that home, just like that. Put that to one side because we're going to be working on the speaker now. This is what the speaker looks like. I'm just going to unravel the wire here. So what we're going to do is we're going to take the connector here, which is going to attach the speaker to the base, and holding it this way, not this way here, that's this side's going to be facing towards the speaker. That's just going to go on top, just like that. We're then going to be bringing over the base again. And it's not hard to see where this is going to go. It's just going to go into this section right here. And it's going to be held in with 2x4mm screws, which are the silver screws again. Now you will find this a little bit trickier because speakers are powered by magnets. Not powered by magnets, but they work with magnets, which are going to want to try and nick your screw. So for that reason, I think I'm going to put a ruler just between where I'm putting the screw to stop that trying to nick it. I could have probably thought of better ideas than using a metal ruler. But there we go. Look, we got the first screw in there now. I'm just revolving the speaker around just a touch because I want this wire to be as close to the circuit board as possible. And there you go. That's the speaker in place. We need to plug the speaker in. That's just going into the large socket that you can see next to these ones here. And push that all the way in. And that is all they want us to do in this stage. We do have some details to go on the base, but we do that later on. We also have these black screws, which you're going to need to save as well. Now, issue 116, we've got another piece of the base, and we've got a very heavy metal plate here, which we're going to be putting in. But we can put that all to one side, bring the base back over, because we've got a couple of tiny details to put in. And they're going to go into the holes that we can see here and here. It's basically these pieces of bone. So I'm just going to put some glue just around the edges here. And get these in. So this one's going this way around. And then finally, we've just got one here. And that's going to go this way. So that's those two details into place. We're going to start putting in the bases now. So I'm going to turn it around so you can see it where the speaker side is. Then we're going to be taking the base from the last stage and we're going to be putting it over the speaker section. So make sure none of the wires are pinched. It's going to go this way and that's going to fit in perfectly like that. It's going to be held in with four of the black screws and these are 3x6mm screws. So I'll get all four of these into place. And then once we've done that, we're going to put in the one that we got in this stage, which is going to go right next to it, just into this section here again, making sure none of those wires are pinched. And once again, four of the large black screws. So now that's just going to leave this large metal section, which we'll be installing in the next stages. Now in stage 117, we're going to start on the battery box. And this is what the battery box looks like. Now, this is going to take C-cell batteries. And I've got some here. So I'm just going to get those all loaded up into the battery box so you can see how these go. Just like that. Takes four of those. We're then going to be putting this top onto the side here. It basically clips on, but it's going to clip on at an angle. So there is a little tab there which will keep that on and keep that in place so nothing's going anywhere there. Then what we're going to do is bring over the base again and this is going to be sliding into this section just here. So as you can see it's going to fit flush in there, but what we do need to do is just unwind the battery cable and that's going to go in the last socket that we've got in this base, which is just over this side here. And there we go, that's fully in now. Once we've done that, we want to train all the wires round, just like this, because we're going to be putting in the next section of base, making sure nothing's pinched there. And once again, that's going to be held in with the black screws. And this last screw here means all four of the black screws are in. Now, if you want to test those batteries, what you can do, turning this back over, is flick this power switch and the lights should flash for a microsecond, which they do. I'm just checking that again. I don't think it's going to pick it up on camera, but that's how you can test that those batteries are working. Now I'm going to put this to one side because we're now going to be working on this metal base. Now this metal base is what's going to eventually hold the Terminator. We're going to have a bar going between these brackets that I'm putting in here. So I'm just going to line these up to kind of show you how this goes. And they're going to be held in with nuts and screws. Now the nut will be going on this side here through the 90 degree plate. Or the bolt, should I say, go through. See, I'm always confusing nuts and bolts here. And then we'll just screw that in from this side. And we just repeat that in the formation that I just showed you how everything's going to go. So by the joys of editing, I'll show you what that looks like. And as you can see, that's all those hinges in place. That's all there is to do in that stage. Now in stage 118, this is literally the backbone of the Terminator, because this is going to house the stand that's going to enable it to stay upright. And this is what the bottom section of stand looks like. Probably best to look at it on the side camera there. We want to put this onto the metal plate, making sure these holes here face outwards. So it's going to go on just like this here. Then we're going to be holding that in place with one of these large screws here. That's just going to go through this side. And it's going to be held by a nut on the other side. And we're going to repeat that 3 more times. And finally, that's the fourth one. Now in the instructions, they put the screws in from the other side, just so you know. I've just realized I've made a mistake there. Wouldn't be the World of Wayne channel if I hadn't made a mistake. I don't think it makes a difference. It's just a little bit more fiddly the way doing it the way I've done it to get the nuts on. But as I said, in the instructions, the bolts here or the screws go through the other way. But as long as it does its job, and that we have got these holes on the outside here, which you can't really see, the holes on the outside here, it should be good. So we're now going to be pushing this into the base. And I have mucked around a little bit with one of the cameras because it's going to be impossible to show you this. We're going to thread this through the holes that we can see in the base, making sure we don't pinch any wires. So one here and one here. Push it all the way down. Till that fits flush in there like that. And we're going to be holding that in with some 3x6mm screws, which once again are the black screws. Now praying you can see this on one of the cameras, the only other thing left to do is put the last panel piece in here. And once again secure that down with 4 black screws. And then we've got these adhesive pads here, looking like that. They're round. We just want to put one of these in each corner. Now this is going to stop any surfaces we put this on being scratched. And it will also protect your model as well. So they're in place. I can now stand this upright. And we're almost ready to put the Terminator into place. Let me just put those batteries back in. The only other thing we've got to do is we've got some spring-loaded clips. Probably best on the side camera here. I'm just going to put the camera up a little bit here, just so you can see what I'm going to do. These are what the clips look like. We're going to fold these into a V, and we're going to push these down all the way onto this section. I've got a flathead screwdriver to help me here, till they pop out the other side here. So push them down. Until it pops out. Then you've got a spring in that section like that. We do the same on the other side. It's imperative that you line this up correctly before you push it down. But that one's good on this side too. Push it down and that comes out as well. And that's all there is to do in that stage. Now in the penultimate stage here, we're going to be actually mounting the Terminator to the other part of this stand. And we also have this chain as well, which we're going to be putting on. But I don't know how we're going to do this because this is going to be really tall. But what we need to do is making sure that we put this way around. So the holes that we've got on this side are facing down. We want to pass these bolts through the holes here so they come up at this side, like that. We want to put a bush just over to the top of those holes there, like that. And then we're going to be putting this metal plate over the top of that. All of that, it's going to sit that way around, is going to be held in with a nut here. I'm just going to put that in gently because we need to kind of do that for all the rest of them as we go along. We're then going to bring over the Terminator base and making sure this section's this way round, so that the holes, let me just show you on the side camera, are facing this section. We're going to put this down, press the slots in here so we can actually slide this all the way down, and then just push it down until it comes out the first hole there. Now with the chain, they're saying you can put that however you want and you can fix this down afterwards. I'll probably do that in post-production, but not quite sure how I'm going to do that yet. I mean, if the skull's down here, it's entirely up to you how you have the chain. But we are now going to be putting the Terminator onto this unit. Okay, so we're going to take these bolts and we're going to be screwing these in as far as we can get them on each side here. That's one. And this one's two. Then I'm going to bring the base down, and all we do is the Terminator is just going to hook onto the back of these sections here and here. So make sure they're all lined up just like that, and there we go, we have a Terminator standing on the stand. The last thing we've got to do is sort out the remote control, and that's the last stage, issue 120. So this is everything in the box here. I'll just get that open. And the first thing we want to do is we've got some transparent fittings here for the remote control on a sprue, so we need to get these off the sprue. Now there are four pieces of these transparencies. So we're going to take the front of the Terminator remote and we're going to just drop these into where they go. So the top one in there. We've got another transparent one just going below it here. And then these two small ones here are just going at the top here. So we've got one going in this side, and then the other one going the other side there. Now we're going to be doing exactly the same thing with the sprue here and putting the pieces in. So I'll take the power button off first, because we know that that's going to go onto the top here. And it is directional, it's got a little notch in there, so when you put it in, it's going to make sure that that's the right way around. Then we've got this sort of like sunshine button here. That one's going to go into that point there. I'm just working my way down the remote control. So the next ones we've got are the arrows here, they're going to go into the top, so we've got one in this side. And one in the other side there. We've got some more arrows to go in here. So again, one in this side here. And one in the other one. It's probably easier to follow my video on this because the instructions aren't really very clear regarding this bit. Then we've got three different sound buttons. So I've got one that's going in this side, one in the middle here, and then one just on the other side here. I think once I've done this, I'm going to take a picture of this and put it up on the screen so you can see exactly what I'm doing. And then we're just going to have the colors here. So we've got the red, which is going to be going on the left hand side of the remote. Obviously, because this is inverted, I've got it on the right side here. So that's the red ones, and then the blue ones are going to go on this side here. One. This is the last button to put in. And there you go, that's all the buttons in place there. Now on the back of this, we're going to want to put the circuit board. So you've got all the buttons on that side, but that's going to keep everything into place here. So it's going to go over the lugs that you can see on the remote control here. Just once they're in place, just like that. I'm just going to gently put that to one side and just open up these screws here, because we want a nut that's actually in here. And you can see the little hexagonal shape there, and we just want to drop a tiny bit of glue just around the edges there, not too much, and put a nut into that section there. So that should fit. I'm just going to put it down nice and flat in there like that. Now we need to take the plug that we got on this side. We're going to be attaching this to the circuit board here, which is a lot harder than it seems. But light it up and then push that all the way in. So now that's connected. Then we're going to do put the whole remote control together. And then that's going to be held in with four 2x4mm screws, which are the silver ones here. The smaller silver ones. So one in there. One in this side. One in this side. And finally, one down the bottom here. Just want to make sure that all the buttons on the other side, before I put batteries in this, are able to be pressed. So that looks good. I've got some batteries here, so we'll put some batteries in. That's one. Make sure that they've got good contacts in there. Here's the second one. Put the top over the battery cover there. And then screw it in with just one of the long silver screw that we got. And that remote is now ready to go. So what I'm going to do, is bring the Terminator up and show you it working. So what we're going to do is take the back of the head off, make sure the battery pack's turned on, and just keep your finger on this button until the lights flash. Just like that. Then we can put the back of the head back on. Now, this is the remote control. Now, first of all, we need to turn the remote control on. So we press the power button on that and it lights up. So we do the top half of the Terminator first. So to turn the lights on and off, we press the sundial there. And as you can see, if I turn it towards Mrs. Wilderwayne, the lights go on and off. Now to move the eyes to the left and right, you keep your finger on these. You can actually touch them as well and they'll just move a little bit like that. Or keep your finger on it and they'll move. And in a similar fashion, we do the same with the drawer. So to open the drawer, we press the down button. And then to shut it again, press the up button. Down and up. So that are all the features of the Terminator. Now, if we go down to the base, we need to make sure the base is turned on. So we just click the switch on there. And then we can operate the spotlights by just pressing these colored lights. So we've got a blue, a red, and a red. And then you just want to angle these up at the Terminator however you feel best. And there you go. You don't have to have them all on. You can just put one on if you wanted to. So you're not unlimited there. And then the sounds. So you've got three sound buttons here. The first sound's going to play the theme. That's enough of that. I don't want to get copyright striked. The middle sound is the sound of machinery and vehicles. And then just press it again there to stop. And then the last sound is going to be just some pulse rifle and laser sounds. Wow, right? How cool is that? Now, obviously, we've got the age-old question of where I put it, because I can't even get it on camera. You could just see his bottom half of his. The other thing you didn't see is, obviously, I've got the plasma rifle here. Not sure if I'm going to mount it with it or without yet. I'll figure that out, how I want to display that afterwards. Probably have a muck around with that chain as well, so that we can get that in the best position possible. And that's going to be one of the features in the workshop. So, Terminator is now complete. Surely agree, it's quite a fun build. That was probably a little bit disappointed with the amount of plastic over metal, but as I said right at the start of the build, that if you had this all metal, the weight would just be far too much. You wouldn't be able to do anything with it. So it's probably in balance, probably the best option. But I really do hope you like that video. If you want to get this for yourself, once again, I'll put the link down the bottom there to the Agora Models website. You can get this all the way from pack one. But I really do hope you liked that video. If you did, please remember to give me a thumbs up. If you haven't subscribed already, please remember to subscribe. Other than that, take care.